Opening up the digital mailbag, well, the free service which gave us our hotline, they went out of business, so it's no longer free. We do have a new service, though. Plug it right into your phone if you'd like. 1-641-715-3900. Again, that's 641-715-3900. And this time you'll have to enter a 6 digits plus the pound sign to get to our mailbox. That's 514049 and pound. And you can find this at the website. Again, the toll-free number is 641-715-3900. And the box number is 514049. And you can log right in. All right, opening up the digital mailbag, Jason says, "Hi, Chris, new subscriber, and I'd like to understand risking no more than 2% on your trades. He'd like to know whether you should risk 2% per trade or 2% of the entire account." Hi, Jason. Everybody has their own risk tolerances. One of the great things about risking no more than 1% on, let's say, 10 trades is that you're never really experiencing more than a 10% drawdown. And this is really important because it really only requires about 11% gain to offset that 10% loss. But as we lose more than 10%, a 50% loss requires a 100% gain just to get back to break even. So most investors, professional investors, never allow their portfolio to risk at any given time of more than 10%. So if you had 5 investments, that's pretty well diversified. You wouldn't want to risk more than 2% on any individual security. And of course, you want to have index diversification among those 5 so that you don't have any overweighting in any particular sector. So you might have a precious metals exposure and energy exposure and equities and, of course, bonds. And then you want to diversify within each of those whenever possible. So, for instance, ticker symbol CEF, the Central Fund of Canada, has a pretty much equal weighting of gold and silver. So you've already got some free diversification lunch within just one symbol. So by not risking more than 2% there, you're actually not risking more than 1% on either of those 2 investments. So there's a lot of ways to look at it, but the key thing is never allow your account to have more than 10% risk at any given moment. And Jason also asks how I like to enter positions and exit them. In thinkorswim conditional option, you have a buy stop to enter a position. So I like the break of a previous weekly high. You can put a sell stop at the bottom of a weekly low. Okay, and this is automatically put in for you. And you can even do a more conditional one that has a third feature, and that is you can split your position into a trailing stop. If your sell stop is never executed, the trailing stop can follow a portion or all of your position up, trailing along the way, never dropping, but always inching higher as the stock or the security makes a advance. Now, that is a bit sophisticated for the everyday investor, the difference it can make for the trader. So for the investor, I don't recommend that third option, just for the weekly trader. And most people would not fall into that designation. You'd really want to be a professional. Why take the risk? You know, a nice diversified portfolio with solid securities, equities, bonds, energy, real estate, and of course, precious metals. That's the way to go. Okay, thanks, Jason. Moving on to Ward in Kashima City, Japan. Wow, we get a lot of callers and email messages from the land of the rising sun. He's a retired businessman and real estate broker and musician and bookseller. He'd like to know how to get a free copy of The Man Who Loved Only Numbers. Of course, that's the fascinating biography of Paul Erdős, the brilliant Hungarian mathematician who lived a very long life and essentially lived nowhere. He just let his mathematician friends, who were very kind, to put him up, and he simply flew all over the world. He was a citizen of the world and escaped tyranny, of course, in Central Europe, and just was a joy to everyone who knew him, who could stand babysitting, I guess you would say, but babysitting a brilliant mind. The Man Who Loved Only Numbers. Also, The Man Who Knew Infinity. I haven't even watched the movie, but I've read the book on the life of Srinivasa Ramanujan at least 3 or 4 times now, and it's just as engaging as The Man Who Loved Only Numbers. And I just so happen to have links to free copies of both, free link to that on Scrib, several links to all kinds of neat books on mathematics and physics, real page turners, including The Life of Galois. Tragic individual, one of the greatest mathematicians that ever existed, passed away at 21 in a duel, sadly. His work, simply because of his rough-and-tumble background, was ignored by most of the cognoscenti at the time, although Fourier and a few other greats did. I think Poincaré as well may have recognized his genius, and sadly was only recognized after his untimely duel. Very humble individual, as his life poured out of him, find the theorems and the lemmas. It's just another neat one, at least the introduction, the first few chapters, I think people would love. There's a few others as well, so I can always send maybe a big compilation of these links, because many of the folks we're going to be hearing from today want those free books. So Ward, if you haven't already received the links, please send it over to me again at gsr@hughes.net. And Martin asks about more free books. He wants to know about Paul Erdős. I think, Martin, I've sent that to you. And David also asks for books about mathematicians. David, I hope I got that to you. If not, please send it over. Then next up, Daniel, longtime listener and subscriber, asks if I've heard about the Ulcer Index for entries and exit positions. Daniel, I haven't investigated that. I'm going to look into that today, and I bet our listeners will too after you suggested it. And if you're into Pilates, Daniel has the book for you. Just ask me for the link. Then Phil, all the way from Canada, says he loves gold. Can't believe our guests are saying only buy as much as you feel comfortable with. He says he's comfortable with as much as he can find. Phil, I think you're really echoing the thoughts and the thinking processes of many of our listeners and most of our guests here. Next up, Chris asks about The Man Who Knew Infinity. Couldn't understand the name of the author. Of course, that's the brilliant Brahmin from southern India, Srinivasa Ramanujan, and just a remarkable individual who loved math, and infinity was just one of the things that he knew. Probably the greatest intuitive mathematician of all time, I believe, at least in the tops. Up there, I think, at least as powerful as Gauss, and certainly Leonard Euler, and so many other greats. He just was a rare individual. And, of course, we can thank G.H. Hardy for that great find. And Susan asks how she can sign up for my Alpha Stocks newsletter for $147. That's a one-year subscription without needing a PayPal account. She'd just like to send in a check. Oh, yes, Susan, you can do that if you like still. Just at 1375 Great Falls Drive, Glenville, North Carolina, 28736. And we'll certainly set you right up. And be sure and include your email address, please, so we can get you set up just right. And then Louie wants another free ebook. Louie, we have those for you. So just send me over a link, and I hope you received them. If you didn't, we'll get one to you. Carl also asks for the free ebooks, and you can be sure we'll send those to you. That's all the Q&A for today. And remember, we now have our phone hotlines. You can reach us anytime you like, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Record, I think it's 3 to 5 minutes. And if you'd like to continue with the recording, we'll splice it all together. You can record till the cows come home. If you like that number again, please jot down 641-715-3900. And the mailbox number, 514049. Coming up after the break, more Gold Seek Radio. The gold and silver mining sector is red hot. Every investment portfolio needs precious metal shares. GoldSeek.com's top stock analysts have done it again, identifying the next solid gold nugget opportunity. Brazil Resources, based in the 8th largest economy with a mining-friendly reputation, almost 10 million ounces of gold reserves. Industry insiders are accumulating shares of Brazil Resources. The notable management team includes Chairman Amir Adnani, a rising star in the mining industry with a reputation for moving projects rapidly into production. Fortune magazine lists Chairman Adnani in the prestigious list of 40 under 40 ones to watch. Plus, shareholders benefit from the insights and backing of enigmatic Brazilian billionaire Mario Garnero, CEO of Brazil Invest Group, the nation's foremost merchant and investment bank, and founding director. Their São Jorge project is 100% owned with paved highway access, a nearby workforce, and a hydroelectric power source near the major gold deposits. Their next top project includes three deposits identified by major gold producers, plus their RIA project, which is a joint venture with Areva, benefits from a $10 million treasure map in the hottest address for uranium production in Canada. But the story gets even more exciting with their Whistler project, offering geographic diversification in South Central Alaska. To find out more about this unique opportunity, please direct your web browsers to BrazilResources.com. At Yahoo Finance, ticker symbol BRI.V. Remember to ride the exciting gold stock run of 2016 and beyond. Your portfolio will thank you for adding shares of Brazil Resources.
GoldSeek employees may or may not own shares. Nothing contained herein should be construed as investment advice.